Would you like to learn the absolute best method of writing off invoices that have become uncollectible from your customers? Well, then you should watch this video, Using the Items Method of Writing Off Uncollectible Invoices. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. This video is a bonus video. It is added to our course after the fact by popular demand from the students who've taken the course. It's not a follow-along step-by-step because it's not really part of our continuous little story that we've been following in this course. In other words, the numbers on the screen won't match the numbers in your account. This is just an interjected video for us to demonstrate how you would write off uncollectible invoices. Now, let's just remind ourselves from the prior video about the context of writing off a customer's balance. Well, you would have to determine that a customer's balance is uncollectible through normal reasons such as bankruptcy, disability, or death. The invoices remain in your customer records as unpaid. So how do you remove them? Well, the name of the deductible expense that this situation creates is called bad debt expense, and we saw this in the prior video. Bad debt expense lowers your profit and net income on your profit and loss statement. Now, what happens when you write off a customer's invoice? Well, the customer's balance is in the accounts receivable account. So accounts receivable will decrease at the moment you write off the invoices. And of course, bad debt expense that represents the money you lost from writing off uncollectible invoices will increase. The method that we learn about in this video is the most appropriate method for non-accountants to write off their uncollectible invoices. It involves three simple steps, where the first step is simply setting up for the method, and the other two steps happen when you write off invoices. Step one, we will set up and prepare QuickBooks Online to be able to use this method by creating a non-inventory part on the products and services list. When we do this, we will connect the item to the bad debt expense account. Well, we already learned how to create a new item. Here we are in the items list. If you want to get there, click the cogwheel, then go over to lists and click products and services, and that will bring you to the list of products and services. Then you will click new. Now, this is a non-inventory part because we're not selling this item to the customer. Double-click, and you can give it any name you want. Let's call this non-collectible, or any name you want, but the most important thing is to connect it to the bad debt expense account. Save and close. So this will be the item that we use, and this will make the bad debt expense account increase at the moment that we write off the invoices. Now, on the day you write off the invoice, you actually create a credit memo and use the bad debt other charge item that we just made and put that on the credit memo. Then, after you record that credit memo, very simply, you then apply the credit memo in the receive payment window. For example, let's imagine on May 6th of 2020, we determined that Alan Arby cannot pay. let's take a quick look at what's going on. We click Reports, and we click the Open Invoice Report, and we see that Alan Arby owes us for two invoices for $1,000 each. So if Alan cannot pay, that means the amount of the write-off will be $2,000, and we have to remove these from the Open Invoice Report. We should also take a look at the trial balance and see, I made it very simple so that you can understand. Right now, the only two accounts in the chart of accounts is the sales income that was earned when we recorded all of our invoices, and the accounts receivable account that represents the total of all of the balances of all of the customers. So if we are writing off $2,000 worth of a customer's balance, accounts receivable will decrease and become $4,000, and you will see bad debt expense appear on the trial balance for the $2,000 that we just lost for writing off Alan's balance. So we will make an item, we have already made an item on the items list called uncollectible invoice or uncollectable or whatever name we gave it. We've already connected it to the bad debt expense account, and now we will do the two other steps. So what was the first step? We create a credit memo. Click New and go down to Credit Memo. We said that the customer was Alan, and that the date that we're writing this off is May 6th of 2020. Now, all we have to do is choose the non-collectible item and put the total amount of the customer's balance. So it does not have to be equal to a specific invoice. It can be equal to all of the invoices that we are writing off in this step. Now, when we click Save and Close, it's so simple. We now see that bad debt expense has appeared in our trial balance for $2,000, and accounts receivable has decreased by $2,000 because a customer's balance has decreased by $2,000. So the trial balance is fine. But when we click Reports, Open Invoice, we can see that Alan's balance is completely gone. It has been written off because the credit memo has been applied to those invoices. And that's why neither of those Alan invoices show up on the open invoice report. Now, you should look at the very last transaction recorded. The very last transaction recorded down here is, notice QuickBooks did you a favor. It made the credit memo for Alan, and then it made a $0 payment. A $0 payment. In other words, behind the scenes, QuickBooks recorded this payment where it applied the $2,000 credit memo to each of the invoices that were still open on our books. And notice the default date that QuickBooks did this for us is whatever date you're doing, not the date of the credit memo. I'm recording this video on May 9th, so it applied the credit memo that lowered the balance to the open invoices that we were writing off, and it applied that automatically and stamped it today's date. And that, my friends, is the best method of writing off invoices.